Alex, just before we go, I want to ask you about Mackay Airport today in Queensland. They've now started on their departure boards at the airport using Indigenous names on some of the departures, causing mass confusion among travellers. There seems to be quite a trend here. Obviously, you've got Fraser Island's been renamed Kigari. That's gone well. We've now ended up with dingo attacks everywhere. This is going to get worse, isn't it? I mean, I tell everyone, if you want to know where we're headed, have a look over at New Zealand. I mean, on their free-to-air TV, they even have their weather maps only using some destinations in Maori. I mean, is anyone ever going to ask us whether we want this to happen? And given that the voice referendum's coming up, you know, if that gets up, you may not know where you're actually flying to.
Yeah, it's a new trend. I don't like it. And I have to say, the first I noticed of this was during an AFL game when the two teams were named with apparently with Indigenous names of some sort, and I couldn't tell who was in front at half-time. So that's where we're headed. That's a very small problem in the grand scheme of things. Not knowing where you're going on a flight is probably a more important one. But yeah, look, of course we are. I mean, this is really all being driven through a broader process. Corporate ESG and their diversity and inclusion targets and every woke corporate trying to out-woke the other one. And this is the real world effect of it. I mean, it becomes almost nonsensical. And, you know, I just want to get back to Sydney and Melbourne. That's what I want to do.
Good on you both, Senator Alex Antic and Nicole Flink. Great to catch up with you both. Have a good night over there in South Australia.